Before optimizing your website, the most important thing you will need to do is keyword research. What this entails is determining what keywords you are going to target on your website. Choosing the right keywords can be the difference between ranking first and not ranking at all. But what do I mean by the right keywords? Well, first let's take a look at an example of a wrong keyword. I have Google open here, so I'm going to do a search for a keyword that would be very popular, computers. As you can see, there are a lot of results for this keyword, several hundred million. You can also see the types of sites that rank in the top 10 for these keywords. They are some of the world's largest and most well-known websites and companies. Targeting a keyword like computers is a mistake for two main reasons. Number one, it is way too broad of a search term, and two, it will be nearly impossible to compete with these websites. So let's begin our keyword research and learn about what keywords we should target. The first thing I want you to do is go to Google and do a search for Google AdWords Keyword Planner. The first result should be for Google AdWords Keyword Planner, so click on that result. In order to use this tool, you will need to have a Google AdWords account, so if you do not have one, pause this video now and sign up. Once you are signed in, you should see the Keyword Planner page, which looks like what you see here. Click on the link that says Search for New Keyword and Add Group Ideas. In the first box, type in a term that is related to your website. So, for example, if your site is an online golf shop, you can type in something that describes one of the items you sell. For this example, I will type in golf clubs. I will leave the rest of the options in this form blank and click on the Get Ideas button. The next thing I will do is click on the Keyword Ideas tab. I now have a list of keywords related to my search, which was golf clubs. For each keyword, there is an average monthly searches number, as well as a competition ranking. My goal is to find a keyword that has a high number of monthly searches with low or medium competition. Here is where you will need to use a bit of judgment, because the number of searches is a relative number, and it will differ based on the industry you are in. When you have located a keyword that you believe is a good fit for your website, it can be a good idea to do a search on that term. Taking a look at the results, how many results do you see? Is there a really high number of results? What about the number of ads? Are there a lot of Google ads for this search term that are competing for business? What about the search results? Are the websites ranking in the top 10 high authority websites that most likely will not be outranked by a newcomer such as yourself? These are things to keep in mind when selecting which keywords to target. Moving forward with our keywords, what I recommend is choosing two keywords per page that you will target. One keyword will be your primary keyword, and the other will be your secondary keyword. This method is only a suggestion, but it will be the method that is demonstrated and applied in the remainder of this video course. So in other words, if you have a one-page website, you should not attempt to target 5 or 10 or even 50 keywords. Targeting two per page will allow you to focus each page and give Google and other search engines a much better idea of what each page is about. This also means that if you are targeting a keyword on a page, that you don't necessarily need to target that same keyword on another page. This would only result in you competing with yourself. Instead, you should find other keywords and different variations of the keyword that you can target. Remember, not everyone looking for left-handed golf clubs will search for that exact phrase. There will be different ways to perform that search, so make sure to focus each page and also broaden your chances at ranking by having different keywords and different variations.